joined by Colin Barr, Senior History Lecturer at the University of Aberdeen in the United Kingdom. He is in Scotland today. Good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon.
What do you say about Hammond's threat to resign and what it says in terms of the state of the UK, of European politics going forward? And of course, as we are now just a couple of days away of finding out who the new Prime Minister is going to be.
I think it's important not to over-exaggerate the importance. Philip Hammond was going to be sacked if Boris Johnson wins. Boris Johnson almost certainly will win. Mm-hmm. Why not first and control the agenda yourself? So that was always going to happen.
Let's talk about what's going on now as we move forward from that point and then, of course, focusing on Brexit, because that sort of went, that is sort of what has spilled over and created all of this. Theresa May working to try and get a Brexit deal and have everything go forward in Parliament. That has not happened. Polls showing, however, the UK is still quite divided on the issue as it was 3 years ago. If we're in the situation right now where there's a no Brexit deal and Boris Johnson saying if he does win come October 31st, Britain is out of the EU regardless.
And that's the real question. Johnson has backed himself into a corner. Britain either has to come out on the 31st or there has to be a short-term extension to allow for some negotiations or implementation. Mm-hmm. But if Britain is not out by the end of this year, Johnson simply cannot sustain that position. The Conservatives were punished at the European elections a few months ago. Britain has to come out now, or Johnson has to fall. If a majority in the House of Commons can be cobbled together to vote no confidence, he could in fact fall. That would likely lead to an election. Right. Perhaps a Remain majority could win that election, but that's very hard to know right now. Because as you say, this country is divided right down the middle.
Very much. And is it pretty much the prediction right now that he will take it on Tuesday?
Everything we're hearing suggests that he's going to win. The only question is the margin. It is likely to be a substantial margin. Certainly what we saw from Philip Hammond today shows that he thinks Johnson's going to win because he knew what was going to happen to him when Johnson did win.
So where was the UK? Where will the UK go from here? Come, let's say, Wednesday now. We have a new prime minister that's there. Things are moving forward from there. If it happens to be Jeremy Hunt, we know that Jeremy Hunt was talking about looking at more of renegotiations. The EU has said in the past that they're not looking to renegotiate. But where do things stand in terms of the UK overall? But I'm sure residents in the UK are wondering, what's going to happen?
Everybody's wondering that, not just here in the UK.
Yeah.
I think the issue whether even if Jeremy Hunt does win, both Hunt and Johnson have pledged to try and renegotiate. They have said that in a new prime minister, situation, the new prime minister, surely the European Union will want to avoid no deal and they'll come back to the table. The European Union, of course, has said, no, we don't want to do that. The issue is there's always been a possible solution if the Irish government is prepared to make a concession on the so-called backstop arrangements on the Irish border. Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to be a big concession, but something that Johnson or Hunt can point to and say, look, I've got something. Then perhaps that could be a way of getting something very like Theresa May's deal, the one that failed three times.
Right. Is that likely, though? Is it potentially realistic?
Unfortunately, the Irish government is even weaker politically than the British government. It's a minority government, depending on support in the Irish parliament, that would likely make political capital of any concession. It would be in Ireland's interest to make a deal, because Ireland will suffer enormously economically from a no-deal Brexit, even worse than Britain will. But it's very hard to see the Irish being able to make a deal. This is the problem. Everybody knows, from Boris Johnson to Leo Varadkar, the Irish prime minister, to the European Union. Everybody knows roughly what the deal should look like. Theresa May's deal plus some kind of change about the backstop.
Right.
Absolutely nobody knows how to deliver it. I think right now the smart money is on Halloween, Britain comes out with no deal. And then we find out if it's going to be a trick or a treat.
Well, I think you just said it there, and the country continues to remain on edge. Colin Barr, Senior History Lecturer at the University of Aberdeen in the United Kingdom. Appreciate this, Colin. Thank you.
Thanks, Angie.
You're welcome.